All Saints Church, Ynysboeth.
As a result of the sinking of the new colliery at Penrhwchaber, the population increased and a new church was needed in Ynysboeth. It consisted of a nave and a south porch, was built in 1903 as a daughter church to St. Winifred's, Penrhwchaber. It became a parish church in the 1920s. It was intended to add a chancel and vestry, but these were never built. The church hall forms the basement to the church. Inside the church is a bronze memorial plaque dated the 8th of November 1948, in memory of those killed in the Second World War. In the late 1990s, major problems arose. The fabric of the church was deteriorating through dampness and dry rot, and this, together with a decreasing membership and lack of funds, the church was facing closure. The opening of the 21st century marked huge positive changes and a remarkable transformation of the church, both structurally and spiritually. The Bryncynon Community Regeneration Strategy, the strategy founded in 1997 and started to raising money to help the community to provide facilities to overcome social problems and poor health standards. In 1996 to 2006, plans were arranged to raise funds for a major restoration of the church structure. The new centre was financed mainly by the big lottery fund. £1.2 million was spent to produce a thoroughly modern appearance with all necessary amenities. Wales' First Minister, Rhodri Morgan, officially opened the centre in October 2006. And it soon earned the title as a state-of-the-art healthy living centre. The ambitious project, so successfully completed, is a fine example of what can be achieved when a church faces closure or even demolition. With adequate funding and foresight, the right combination of enthusiastic people and circumstances, and a great deal of providence, anything is indeed possible.
March 26, 1923. The vicar announced that the district of Tintown and Ynysboeth had been made a parish and a vote of congratulations was accorded. Parochial Council Meeting, December the 20th, 1926. On account of the church being somewhat damaged by fire, arrangements had to be made for the carrying on the necessary services. Proposed and seconded that services be held in the church hall. Proposed and seconded that we endeavour to get a temporary covering from the roof and also that the loose slates be removed.
October 2nd, 1938. Special meeting. Vicar explained that the chief business was to consider ways and meanings of raising money.
Very often we would fundraise and we would take the children and we'd walk all the way up over Perth Celyn down to cross the targets down into the bull to Llanwynnog, and then we would go, it's the old bull road, and we'd go over to Llanwynnog. Eventually then we'd all sit at Penrhwchaber Church and our church, and then we would have a lovely barbecue to finish the evening off.
June the 5th, 1939. There followed discussion of the Sunday school's outing, time of departure, Matthewstown Hall at 11 a.m. Train to leave Barry at 9:15 p.m. An estimate of numbers are likely to go. Mrs. M. Davis reported that some 200 adults and 200 children went the previous year. Estimated cost for Sunday school solas would be £10. The vicar stated that kind friends of his had given £11 towards expenses of children's outing.
Easter Vestry Meeting, April the 3rd, 1940. The meeting opened in prayer, then followed an expression of condolence to all who had suffered bereavement in the last years. All present stood in silence. Vicar said a review of all that had been done in the preceding year was hardly necessary, for everyone present had been close in touch with the working of church.
February the 4th, 1945. A further matter for discussion among the PCC was mentioned, that namely that of the war memorial to those that fell in the war. What form it would take, a stained glass window, a breastplate on the church wall, and methods of making a collection.
October the 7th, 1945. Report of progress of Memorial Fund. Mr. M. Davis said that a sum of £17, 18 shillings and one penny had been collected in his area.
Hello, everybody. Little tales and stories from All Saints. I've got loads of stories to tell you from All Saints, but one story is every Palm Sunday we'd be down in the garden and we'd all have palms and we'd be waving them. But they didn't know, before we had the palms, I'd go down to Mary the Bishop's hedge, cut loads of palms off, bring them up, give them to everybody, then I would ask Mary the Bishop, is it all right if I've had some palms from your hedge? Which Mary didn't mind anyway. That was lovely, we always done that. Started from the outside, worked our way in. The children were loving it. It was wonderful.
My grandfather, John Daniel Moore, was the church warden for many years in All Saints. And my father used to go to church three times a day. He had a wonderful voice and he was singing in the choir. He ended up, him and his sister used to play the accordion and he'd sing. They were at the London Palladium with the Billy Thomas Band.
23rd of March 1981. Dear Sir, please accept this letter as confirmation of the receipt. You will receive an enclosed cheque for £10 on behalf of officers and committee. The committee was only too glad to make a gift of bingo machines.
Our school teacher on a Sunday morning was a Miss Janice Brettle that used to live down by you. And we do colourings, tracing, and she'd teach us about God and everything like that. Also, when I was little, there used to be a lot of functions going on at the church. There used to be jumble sales. And people would be queuing from the bottom of the church, past the gate, up the top, for a jumble sale. Also, they used to do fancy dress. And me and my friend up the road, we both went as gypsies. And we won first prize, a big bar of Cadbury's milk. But before we left the church, somebody pinched it. In later years then, they did used to hold bingo. I think it was on a Monday night, and a lot of the people around the tent and yeah, used to go up for bingo.
I remember All Saints Church, and I used to serve on the altar, yeah. It was good serving on the altar, and remember it as it was.
And Christmas time was another lovely time. Carols and so on, to get the festivals, as we do in the other churches. It kept up everything very well. And there were some very, very faithful people here. And they all enjoyed it. So the church goes on. And we're only pleased to think that it is being used now for the community. That pleases us, because had they not allowed for the church to be used as a church, this wouldn't be existent now, you see. And it's a wonderful place, but the people are really, really wonderful.
My sister now introduced me to St. Winifred's. That's over 60 years ago there. And I had three girls, and they all been confirmed and christened there. And my little one was there, she used to be on the altar. And all boys. She was the only girl that was on the altar. We joined Mother's Union now, like in it. And it was lovely in Mother's Union. And we used to go on a table on our own because we were young wives. And then the Mother's Union, they were the boss. They were the boss of us. We had to behave ourselves. And it was lovely. And then, you know, I joined them and it was lovely to have things every week, something to do. Somebody would learn to come to cook, or somebody would learn to tell you what about your cooker and all this and that. It was like, they don't do it now like it is, you know. My husband, he'd do anything for church. Because he never used to see much of me on Christmas time. No Easter time. I'd be more in church than everything. They used to say, where's your mother? Well, where do you expect her to be? She's in church. I used to go to church regularly, see. But of course, like that, I do have my little services on my own, yeah. They send me all the stuff, all the gin, you know. And there's a nice letter from the people from Zlanda. And a Christmas card, and a birthday card, and an Easter card I do have, you know, and a lovely letter often. Fair play, you know, they keep me in the swim.
I know the yoga was well attended, because I used to go to Optic, because that's where I live, but one of my yoga instructors did once a week, I think, I don't even know
Right.
And that was well attended. So, you got the building, with the building is perfect, it's modern, it's adapted for disabled access.
Yeah. When we had a new priest here, for some reason, and he was a lovely priest, old priest, quite plump, and he came here first up as nine. He goes up to St. Winifred's then. But the chap here now, the priest, I forget his name, he, at the end of the service, he wanted to go to the toilet. Yes, of course we got a toilet, Father, you can go. Use the lift, go down in the lift, which he did. And he was in there exactly 2 minutes, and he was stuck in the lift. And he was busting to go to the toilet, poor thing. And he was red in the face. And not one of us could open the... We didn't know how to release him from the lift. Stephanie Bruford was here. The children were looking at him about 2 foot down, waving and saying, Father, are you all right? He was like a goldfish in a bowl. But we ended up, Stephanie Bruford found a way, put a big pencil in a hole. He didn't go down with a bang. We brought him up gently. But then he went back down. Okay, went to the toilet and come up. And he said, oh, thank you very much. Now, we know churches about church services and about the priest we have. But we have happy times and we have funny times. And I do remember the time when Mary the Bishop dropped the altar. It wasn't on wheels then, but we did put wheels on it after. Mary the Bishop dropped the altar. Mary the Bishop nearly knocked you out with a cross. Everything is fun. You have your lovely services, but we also have lots and lots of fun, and they are lovely memories for me to share with you about All Saints Church.